Okay, I've cut my round piece out. Let's put this ladder so we don't get quite as much glare. I've cut the round piece out, and because it was a piece of copper that had been around the shop, there were some scratches, so I cleaned it very well with some pumice stone to make it a really nice matte surface. Scribed the lines on I need in order to put my script in and make sure everything's even. And now what I'm going to do is drill a little hole in the center. Now the reason for that is I'm going to use a gauge, which is I made so that I can space my letters correctly. This is a just under 3 degrees of a circle between these two sides. So as I can scribe a line, move this over, and scribe my next line for my letters so that I know that my spacing is going to be uniform and it's going to look nice. It took me a few tries to figure it out and get the spacing right, but I think I got it down. This is my drill bit, so let's take the drill bit and pop it in here. And I would not recommend that method for beginners of putting in drill bits. It takes a lot of practice. You learn to do it. Make sure that the drill bit is rotating smoothly. Put a little lubricant on there. And then we're going to put it on the center here. Time I think he used a pin, but I'm not sure where that pin is anymore. I believe I used just like a little. No. So when you find a pin, we'll use that. Or I might use a. Let's see if I can find a little busted saw blade here. Or a dull drill from before. Yep. And I should be able to use this, nail this into there. When you're nailing something, always use a hammer that's got a rough face. It's meant for nailing stuff. This one. Okay, good. That's reasonably attached. There's our saw piece on our with the scribes and our saw piece. Now, this is the scribe I normally use for stuff, but it is a little bit too wide, so I'm going to use something else for a scribe. We're going to look over here first. Let me just get a sharper, finer point. Oh, I don't want to use a graver. actually this might work really good at that point. No, but it rocks, so... Ah, well, there's a pin I was using. But it's a little big. Actually, this will work, so we'll use this. Okay, now... I have to do this upside down because I want to work here, not at the top. So we're going to put this piece of paper here. And as I mark a letter, I will slide this sideways and do more. So basically, you want to go here. One is all angles, so this is where it gets a little funky. This file blade is about the same width. Space a little too far apart. Let's find something that's a little less. This is the fun part. You get eyeball stuff. Rip that out, so and I'm not liking that at all, so what we do is we sand that off with a little bit of 600. Okay, so we have this one. Oops. Okay, so we have here, and we have three lines at the top side, and then four lines at the bottom. Two, three, four at the bottom. And I did the wrong spot, so we mark that one out. Go. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4. And we have one that's full length. So we'll go there. Cover up this last one just barely with the copper here. And draw one full length. We have five on the inner edge. Two, three, four, five. Two at the upper edge. I'm not making a mistake like I did earlier with it between the lines. Four on the bottom. Or, well, the four on the inner edge, I should say. Two, three, four on the upper edge. Two, three, four. One, two, three, four. You have five full length ones. four full-length ones. So I'm going to leave a little gap so it's pretty obvious. No, not that much, just a little bit. Four full length ones. I need 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 5 on the inner edge. The reason I'm counting and double checking is because if I get the wrong number of lines, it says something different, because that's the actual alphabet. The lines make the alphabet. So I got 5 on the lower and 1, 2, 3, 4 on the upper section. Section, and we're over halfway done, and all we got, okay, got 4 full length ones. Four on the inner edge. One, two, three, four. Yep. So I got the 4 and the 1. Have a full length one. Now I have 1, 2, 3, 4 of the slanted ones. So slanted ones. Okay. sanding this off and doing it again, because it might be a little too tight. I need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 2 long ones. Not have enough space, so I will be redoing this after I make my gauge a little narrower yet again.